everyone, and welcome to Lety Does Kingdom. So, in the last episode, we saw, that the prince and his new following of people need to deal with the fact that zombies will no longer be just corpses in the morning, because what they had initially believed to be the sunlight that made them shut down is wrong, because it's actually the heat, and now it's winter. So the last episode picked up immediately where the season finale ended off, and just a horde of zombies crashes into the wall that they were relying on so much, and they have to run through some old tunnels that were created during the war and get to a safer town thing. So the prince and the remaining survivors go there to regroup and come up with a plan on what to do with all these zombies that are now gonna be awake all the time. So they decide that they are going to go to, I don't remember the name, but the princess's father's kingdom to go and kill him, because he's the one that started the zombie outbreak for getting too ambitious and stuff. So anyway, he comes up with a plan where some members of his group are going to distract the zombies by luring them to one side of the wall, and then he's basically just gonna run across, and we don't know how that went, but that's his current plan at the moment. At the same time, the medicine woman, who was on the run from the zombies in the cave, has gone to the city that the prince is going to be at, with the leader's, I believe, nephew? I'm not sure what relation he has to them. They're blood related. And the two of them have been allowed to stay within that kingdom and have been given protection just because basically the guy is related to him. The lady is trying to study the properties of the plant that was used to bring people back to life so that she can hopefully find a remedy to it. But she's had no luck as of yet, and as she's studying it further, the guy comes and asks her what she's doing and if she knows what that is. And she says yes, and then he says that then he will use her because something is not finished yet. So I don't know if she's going to have to bring more people back from the dead or something to do with the king, but we're probably gonna find out right away. And that's what happened in the last episode. I'm liking the show so far. I like the effects, I like the story, so I'm just hoping that that continues. And that's basically all I'm looking for. Kingdom, Season 2, Episode 2. Let's get started. Is that a spoon? Is it, or like a shovel? What's that gonna do? Well, between the fact that there's so little people and the box, which is obviously holding the zombie king or something, it's a trap, right? Oh snap, the blood from the sword. Well, he brought a sword to a gunfight. to start a fire. Fuck it. Set everything on fire. Now is not the time for hallucinations, boy! Birthright.
You are my only son.
Ooh, this looks really pretty. I don't think the emotional approach will necessarily work. So if the prince was to kill his father right now, and even if this guy was to make a big old stink about how he murdered his dad, wouldn't the throne still go to him? Aww, not him too. Aw, he was so close. Didn't the prince say he was gonna kill this dude? Now seems like his chance. I had a feeling that's where they were going with this. They should have just let him crash through the wall and had him try to eat everyone. This guy is too righteous and for the law, he's gonna die. Oh no! Oh, okay. Well, these guys are on foot, so I don't think they can get very far matching with the guys on horse. No, you don't want that. That already happened once. Ooh, that's cool looking. Well, isn't that convenient? Oh, come on, subtitle me! I don't know what that says! Oh shit, he actually got him? Aww. So close. I know those screams. Those are zombie screams. What the fuck is that? Oh, he asked her to bring him back to life? Oh my god. Well, he didn't go down easy the first time. Oh, gross. This is a cool looking shot though. Alright, so, this was a really cool episode. I really enjoyed that last scene. It was nasty, but the camera framing and then like the exposure, it was good. It looked good. That was cool. Really cool. Anyway, I don't really get what's the queen's plan, or... Yeah, have I been calling her princess? No, she's queen. She's queen. I don't really get what's the queen's plan, because she could have just, like, had someone be there for, like, the birth of all these kids, and just, like, paid attention as to, like... who gives birth to a boy? And then if there is someone that gives birth to a boy, like, just kill that specific person instead of being there for the birth of 7 different women. And then, like, if they have a girl, smothering them, which is weird and unnecessary. But I mean, if her character is supposed to be as vicious as possible, I guess that's why they did it. What I also don't get is how she's going to fake the birth of a newborn baby. They could have just had her, like, you know, give birth really fast and then maybe, like, toss a little bit of blood on that baby, get it cleaned up after, you know, have only her trusted advisors be her nurse maids birthing partner things. I don't know. I don't entirely get it, but it's probably just dragging out the whole, like, she gave birth to a boy thing so that for us as the viewer, the prince has, like, a greater chance of actually succeeding at getting his throne back, rather than she just gives birth to a boy and that's it. But I'm interested in how fast all this is progressing, because we're only in episode 2, and I think that was her father that got bitten at the end there, so he's down, which only leaves her, and she has to still give birth to a boy for her to be in charge of the throne. But now that everyone thinks that the prince is a traitor, I guess there's that as well. Anyway, I'm not sure. Let me know what you guys thought of this episode. Your thoughts on the show thus far, in general. And that's basically all I got for you for now. So get out there, do all the stuff, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
Hey everyone, Lety here. Just trying on another outfit for my Spring of Secondhand Shops try-on haul, March 2020. And if you want to see me wear this striped floral outfit, then you can go ahead and vote for it by checking out that video down there. Bye!